got a story to tell you. He wouldn't let the devil consume me. Because God knew he could use me. God is no respecter of persons. What he's done for me, he'll do the same for you. Yeah, he's no respecter of persons. What he's done for me, he'll do the same for you. Listen, cause he's giving you the same.
To God. That was William Murphy singing Same Grace. Amen. Same Grace. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Welcome to another segment of Faith in Action. I am your host, Mary J. Bryant. Do I dare say Dr. Mary J. Bryant? Yes, you heard me. by the grace of God, He has allowed me to earn my Doctor of Divinity. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Same grace. Same grace. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. William Murphy, the same grace. That I heard that song and I'm like, yes, yes. Let me read some of the lyrics to you. He said, and after all that I've been through, I got a story to tell you. He wouldn't let the devil consume me because God knew He could use me. God is a known respecter of persons. He is no respecter of persons. What He does for me, He'll do the same for you. God is not a respecter of persons. What He has done for me, He'll do the same for you. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. God has the same grace for each one of us. Glory to God. But we have to believe that grace by faith. Amen. Because there will be some times in our lives. There are times in my life, let me speak personally, that I don't feel the grace. But I know grace is on me to get through whatever that thing is. I don't feel like I'll get through. But by faith, I believe it is so. Amen. That I will get through it. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Well, I will I'll be sitting down on this segment. And it's actually a teaching, discussion, refresher, if you will, about our faith and how our faith should be on fire. Amen. I had the humble opportunity to lead a clergy class on yesterday. And I meant to say lead and not teach, because those who are in the class as clergies, they already know about faith. But the Lord told me as I stood there that this would be a refreshing. It would be a moment of contemplation. It would be a moment to recollect how far God has brought each one of us who were in the class on yesterday. And I can speak for myself that I was truly blessed, even as the leader of that class. Others also said they really needed that class because they were in a place of a slump. They were in a place just of being burdened down, of being heavy laden. Amen. Glory to God. So I am truly humbled that God chose me to be at that appointed place at that appointed time. Amen. With God's people. Amen. Because iron sharpens iron. Doesn't the Bible tell us that? We need more of that in the body of Christ. Amen. There's too much bashing. There's too much suspicion. There's too much bad vibes. There are too much bad words, negative words about us in the body of Christ. Amen. We look at each other through the wrong lenses. Our lenses are muddy because we're looking at us, each other, through our own carnal minds. But get into the Word of God and begin to see what God says about yourself and about me and about your brother and your sister, and watch how the Word, you mix it with faith and believe God, watch how the people start changing. Watch how you start to change. Faith on fire. Our faith has to be on fire, lest there's no faith at all. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. I started off the lesson asking everyone, what is their personal definition of faith? Amen. And I said, don't tell me the Bible's definition of faith. Amen. But I want your personal definition. What do you believe your faith is? And they gave some wonderful answers One person said that if they had confidence in God, the next person said that they believed that God's word never changes. And I'm just giving you like just a one word encounter on that, because I can't bring it back, okay, verbatim. Another person said their faith is seen in endurance. Another person said that when they heard that God never changes, you know, different faith definition. That was a personal. God wanted everybody to stand on their own faith and discuss and talk about their faith, not nobody else's faith, not their mama faith, not their daddy faith, not their grandmama faith. Amen. Glory, but their faith. Glory to God. So it was wonderful. And we know that faith is not a religion. Many times people say we have our faith. What they mean is this: we have our religious ideas and doctrines, our traditions, our ways of doing things passed down through the generations. But this is not the Bible faith. Faith is not mental approval. It is not agreeing with your mind. Many professing Christians believe mentally that the Bible is the Word of God, but this faith does not change the way they live. Did you hear that? It is not a faith that can save. Faith on fire. If your faith is not on fire, if your faith is not in action, as James 2 and 14 states, then it's no faith at all, because faith changes us. Faith changes us. Amen, amen. Paul says, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation. For from faith to faith, righteousness is revealed. Therefore, as our faith is on fire, and as we go from faith to faith, the levels of faith, the righteousness of God is revealed in us as Jesus. Glory to God, our faith on fire. Then I ask, how has your faith changed your life up to this point? To give an example, and we gave some great examples. I mean, you could see the oil on them as they spoke. As they look back from their beginnings, amen, in walking with God, amen, to that very moment in class, that you could see the glow, you could see the confidence, you can see them hold up a little bit stronger, because now they were giving their own testimony back to themselves. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Realizing that, oh my God, you know, challenges come in life, but I can still believe and stand on the word of God by faith. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Then I shared my journey through my secondary education steps. And I'm not going to get into it. Maybe one day I'll write a book about, you know, my journey, my before Christ and after Christ journey. Amen, amen, amen. But it was a wonderful discussion on looking back and now seeing how their faith is on fire. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. And faith is not a way to manipulate God. Let me say that again. Faith is not a way to manipulate God. Because remember, God is not mocked, nor is he deceived. So as a man soweth, so shall he reap. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Let me pull that up. I'm going to pull that up. Let me pull that up for a second. Because I was reading that not too long ago, and something jumped out at me. Something jumped out at me, and I just wanted to got to my background music. I like my instrumental soaking music. That's in Galatians 6 and 7. in Galatians 6 and 7. And we always, we stop there, but listen what, turn that down a little bit. Listen what verse 8 follows up and say. That's Galatians 6 and 7. It says, the one who sows to please his flesh from the flesh will reap destruction. But the one who sows to please the Spirit from the Spirit will reap eternal life. See, so God's not mocked. He's not mocked at all. We can't fool God. We can't manipulate him. Amen. We may try to manipulate each other, but we can never manipulate God. Amen. Glory to God. It is not a power by which we make God do what we want, when otherwise he would be unwilling to do that thing. In other words, God will not do anything that's contrary to his word. No matter what we say, no matter what we do. And I hear many talk about how they're coming to God and how they're living for God and how they're doing ministry. But you cannot make God accept your crooked way of doing things. Amen. Amen. You cannot manipulate him. You cannot bully God into doing that. God is holy. God will do exactly what he knows to do, and nothing contrary to his word shall he do. He will not deviate from his word. It is not a kind of magic through which we make God into our servant. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Our faith on fire. Our faith on fire. Faith is not hope nor positive desire. You hear the world talk about, you know, positive thinking, positive this. That's all well and good for the world, but we have to go beyond the positive thinking and positive this. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. But it's the power of God in our lives. It's the same grace in our lives. Glory to God. Hope is good and relates to the future. Faith, however, takes the promise as done now. You get it? Hope is future. Hope is the unseen. Though we walk by faith and not by sight, faith is now, because we believe that thing that we have not yet gotten, that we have gotten it now. We have it right now in our hands. Amen. Glory to God. We have it in our hand. We have to have the settled confidence and present assurance which faith has. Amen. Faith on fire. Mark 11:24 tells us, therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire, when we pray, believe that ye receive them, and you shall have them. We have to pray, we have to believe, and tell God, thank you, I receive it, before we get a thing. That's faith. That's now faith. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. With that being said, when we do receive eternal, when do we receive eternal life? John 3:36 says, that we receive eternal life the moment that we believe and receive Christ Jesus, and we are born again. We have eternal life. Amen. Amen. That's a, it's a faith on fire thing. You're not, you have to believe that by faith, that you have a dual life. You have a life here in time, and you have a life in eternity already. Amen. Why? Because our life is in Christ Jesus. And where is he? He's seated at the right hand of the Father. Amen. Amen. You know, sometimes I hear people talk about being at the feet. That's the highest we can get, is at the feet of Jesus. I get that in a sense that Mary, remember Mary and Martha? Mary sat at the feet of Jesus to soak in what he was saying. Amen. Amen. Dual life. But in the spiritual realm, glory to God, we are seated in Christ Jesus in the heavenlies. God has placed us in Christ, and Christ is in God. Amen. The Bible talks about, so such as he in heaven, we so are we on the earth. It is a faith walk. Faith on fire. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Why? And let me pause here and give you a testimony. God told me, I was like, I'm always like, God, what am I going to say? How do I prepare? You know, blah, blah, blah. And he would say, just go. You can put some stuff on the paper, but I just want you to go and stand. And the rest, I would do the rest. And he did the rest because I did not get, I kid you not, the first page, I did not get past, actually, the first page, that question I asked about how has their faith changed up to this point, that was it. Nothing else on my paper I went to because the Holy Spirit took over. And we just came together and let iron sharpen iron. Amen. Glory to God. Be a refreshing. Be refreshed in that moment because we need that in the ministry. Amen. We need that. You don't even have to be in the ministry. In life in general, we need to be refreshed. When we go through so much, amen, we need to be refreshed. But especially those who are spiritual sons and daughters of God, we need to be refreshed. Amen. Glory to God. Oh, because listen, we have to watch as well as pray, but we also have to be refreshed because Satan never leaves his post. He never leaves his post. Amen. 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 So why do you believe faith is necessary for Christians? Go ahead and answer that. I may not be able to answer you, but you can type it in the comment box on my YouTube channel. Amen. Amen. Or you can go to my Facebook page. Amen. Mary J. Bryant, and could become a member of the Faith in Action page. Amen. And give me your comment, your answer. We need faith because it's impossible to please God without it. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. We cannot believe in a God we have not seen without faith. And who gives us? We are given the measure of faith to believe that God is. And he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. So what is faith? What is faith? In the general sense of the word, to have faith is to believe in something or someone, to fully trust, to be so confident that you base your actions on what you believe. To have faith is to be fully convinced of the truthfulness and reliability of that in which you believe. Faith in God, then, is to have the kind of trust and confidence in God and in Christ that leads me to commit our whole soul to him as Savior, as our justifier, as our cleanser, as our healer, as our provider, as our deliverer, as our restorer, amen, as our redeemer. Glory to God. And Lord, Master, King, amen, of our lives. Glory to God. We know that Hebrews 11:1 tells us, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Faith is a spiritual substance. I'm going to say that again. Faith is a spiritual substance. Therefore, when we have this spiritual substance in us, it communicates to us a certain inner knowing that the thing you are hoping for is certainly established even before we see it manifest. Glory to God. Glory to God. You ever heard or was talking to someone and they said, I just know it in my knower. I just know it deep inside of me. I just know that it is so. I don't care if I don't see it. I don't care if I don't feel it. I don't care what is going on. I just know that God said a thing and I believe a thing. I'm waiting for it. Although I have it, I receive it. I'm waiting for it to manifest. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. See, faith in God is a spiritual force. Faith in God is a response to God's word, which moves God to act. God's words mixed with real, pure faith can move mountains. Glory to God. That's what the Bible tells us. We have to believe that. I've seen the quote that says, faith it till you make it. Amen. Keep trying your faith. Keep putting your faith on the fire. Amen. Keep going through the test. Keep going through the test. Keep going through the trial until your faith, amen, is in activation. Amen. Glory to God. No one can tell you different. Amen. Amen. Faith in God must be from the heart. It is not merely intellectual. It is spiritual. The Bible says, for with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Romans 10 and 10. Amen. We quote Romans 9 and 10, but we don't go and explain what 9 means by going to verse 10. Amen. Amen. We have to believe unto righteousness in our heart. That's why we're given the breastplate of righteousness in the armor of God. It's a heart thing. It's a spirit thing. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. It's not about coming down the aisle and putting your name on the church roll. It is about coming and believing by faith, being convicted of your sin, by repenting to God and putting your faith in Jesus, and coming and putting your trust in Him and following after Jesus, making Him Savior and Lord of your life. Amen. And faith will change you. It will change you. It's for with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Romans 10 and 10. Don't just stop at Romans 9 and 10 or 10 and 9. Amen. Don't just stop there. And we know that righteousness, the righteousness of God, is revealed, as I said before, from faith to faith. Amen. Amen. Because faith changes us. Faith transforms us. Amen. Because of our salvation. Our faith in our salvation changes us. Faith causes us to know in our heart before we see with our eyes. For we walk by faith, not by sight. 2 Corinthians 5 and 7. The world says seeing is believing, but people of faith say believing is seeing. Amen. Glory to God. Faith on fire always has corresponding actions. We talk what we really believe. And listen at that. We talk what we really believe. So what are you talking? What are you saying? Amen. Because it will reveal what you believe. If you are saying things contrary to the word of God, then you believe the enemy and not God. Because we have two counsels. We have the godly counsel and the ungodly counsel. Amen. Amen. Two counsels, godly and ungodly. It's just two. Man has two decisions, two choices to choose from, godly and ungodly. Whether we're going to follow the voice of Satan or we're going to follow the voice of God. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Faith on fire. Faith on fire. We talk what we really believe and we act according to what we really believe. Amen. Our actions even shows our faith. Our action shows what we believe. Amen. If you believe that you're the head and not the tail, then act like the head and not a tail. Glory to God. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. The heroes of faith, like Abraham, were considered men of faith because they acted on what God showed them. They acted on their faith. We've heard the story about Abraham over and over again. Amen. Amen. How he believed God and he was accounted to righteousness by God. And God called him his friend. Amen. Glory to God. Faith is rest. Oh, faith is rest. We don't have to fret about that thing we believe we have, but we haven't seen it yet physically manifested. We can rest in God. Why? Because God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. For if he spoke it, then he will make it good. Amen. And all his promises are yes in Christ Jesus. And we say amen to the glory of the Father. Amen. God will do exactly what he said he's going to do. I believe that. I believe that. Amen. Glory to God. I believe that on today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Faith in God is the key to pleasing God. Amen. I said it before. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Faith releases the blessings of God. It brings God onto the scene. Amen. It brings God onto the scene. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Remember, in the Bible, the Roman soldier, amen, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. The Roman soldier came to Jesus, amen. The officer came to Jesus and wanted Jesus to heal his daughter, and his servant, his servant, that was Jairus I was thinking about, but his servant to be healed. And when Jesus heard this, let me read this. Matthew 8:5 through 13. It says, when Jesus returned, a Roman officer came and pleaded with him. Jesus said, I will come and heal him. But the officer said, Lord, I am not worthy to have you come into my home. Just say the word from where you are, and my servant will be healed. When Jesus heard this, he was amazed. Turning to those who were following him, he said, I tell you the truth, I haven't seen faith like this in all Israel. Isn't that something? Isn't that something? Glory to God. Isn't that something? God was amazed by the Roman soldier, the Roman officer, because he said, you don't even have to go. If you just speak it, if you just speak the word, it'll be so. Because he knew, even being a Roman officer, he already knew who Jesus was. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Jesus said, he was amazed. He said, he turned and he told them, he said, I haven't seen faith like this in all Israel. Faith on fire. Faith on fire. God will do exactly what he says he will do. Psalms 127, I believe, says, God, send your word and heal them. And his word healed. He just got to speak it, and the word comes alive. Wherever he sends the word to, it comes alive. Amen. Here is a man who knew what authority is all about. This Roman officer knew that Jesus had such authority that he believed his request for the healing of his servant would be given him without the need for the Lord to personally come, but only needed to say the word. Hallelujah. Has God said any words over your life on today? Are you believing it to come to pass at the set time it's supposed to? Is your faith on fire? Amen. Glory to God. Is your faith on fire? Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Does your faith in God allow you to believe that his word will do what it says? Ask yourself that. Ask yourself that question and go and give me that answer. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and I would love to hear your answer. Then there was the woman with an issue of blood. Mark 5:25-34 said a woman in the crowd had suffered for 12 years with constant bleeding. She had heard about Jesus, so she came up behind him through the crowd and touched his robe. For she thought to herself, if I can just touch his robe, I will be healed. Immediately the bleeding stopped and she could feel in her body that she had been healed of her condition. Then the woman was frightened, trembling at the realization of what had happened to her, came and fell to her knees in front of Jesus and told him what she had done. And he said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace. Your suffering is over." Amen. Oh, her faith was on fire, wasn't it? For 12 years. Amen. For 12 years. Shekorabasheke. I was in a place for 12 years. For 12 years. And my faith was set on fire during those 12 years. But at the end of the 12 years, I was set free by my faith on fire. This is another powerful story. This woman struggled through the pressing crowd to just touch Jesus' robe because she believed she would be healed. She believed that she would be healed if she could just do that. If her faith could just touch his robe, because her faith was on fire. She tried everything else. Nothing else worked for 12 years. But she knew if her faith could touch the word, then she knew she would receive her healing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And she experienced the healing power of Jesus. How about you? Do you have faith enough to touch his robe and believe that that thing you are believing by faith will be provided for you immediately, right then, that you don't have to wait, that it'll happen like that? Have you ever experienced that type of immediate answer to your prayer, to what you were believing by faith? Has your faith been on fire like that before? Do you desire for it to happen like that? Well, it can. You have witness here that I'm reading to you. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Then remember the Gentile woman in Matthew 15, 21 and 28. Said, "Then Jesus went north through the region of Tyre and Sidon. A Gentile woman who lived there came to him pleading, 'Have mercy on me, O Lord, son of David, for my daughter is possessed by a demon that torments her severely.' But Jesus gave her no reply, not even a word. Then his disciples urged him to send her away. Then Jesus said to the woman, 'I was sent only to help God's lost sheep, the people of Israel.' But she came and worshiped him, pleading again, 'Lord, help me.' Jesus responded, 'It isn't right to take food from the children and throw it to the dogs.' She replied, 'That's true, Lord, but even dogs are allowed to eat the scraps that fall beneath their master's table.'" Oh, God. Isn't that wonderful? She worshiped Jesus. She didn't take no for an answer. Amen. Glory to God. But don't you know Jesus knows all things? And he already knew that this lady was going to be persistent and not stop until she received what she needed from him for her daughter by faith. He said, "Dear woman, your faith is great. Your request is granted." And her daughter was instantly healed. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Three times Jesus was amazed at the faith of these people. The Roman officer, the woman with the issue of blood, and the Syrophoenician woman. Amen. For her daughter. He was amazed by it. and they receive what they ask for immediately, instantly, right then and there. Amen. Glory to God. Faith is now. Amen. Whether you receive it now or at the appointed time, you have to have faith on fire. Amen. You have to believe that God is so good that He wants good for you, that you can pick up His word. Amen. You can believe what He says. You can believe what He says you can have through faith. Amen. Glory to God. That's not to manipulate God, but that's to bring God into your situation, and He will work it out for you. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. 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 Without faith on fire, we can have assurance in God. Without faith on fire, we can endure the trials and the testing and the tribulations that we go through. Without faith on fire, we can receive correction and chastisement from God. Amen. Amen. Without faith on fire, we can love one another. Without faith on fire, we can come together. Amen. As one body in Christ. Amen. Amen. One Lord, one Spirit, one God, one baptism. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. As I said in class, and I'm almost finished. As I said in class yesterday, and Holy Spirit told me that once the topic was given to me, He said, Mary, a faith on fire will be under fire. So don't count it strange when you endure diverse kinds of trials. Peter talks about that. But be encouraged. Amen. There is a reason for your faith on fire being under fire. Amen. There is a testing that has to take place. Amen. We have to endure. Amen. To the end. That's why these things happen. Jesus told His disciples, He said, I go away to prepare a place for you, and I'm coming back for you. So not only for His disciples, we have to be prepared for that prepared place. And I believe our faith on fire will be under fire, so we can be prepared to endure to the very end. For our goal of our faith is salvation. Amen. And salvation shall be completed. Amen. Once we leave this earth. Amen. Or Jesus comes back, whichever is first for either for each one of us. Amen. Glory to God. For we know that we all won't sleep, but we will all be changed in a twinkling of an eye. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. How have your faith been tested, or what was or is your greatest testing of your faith? I didn't even get a chance to ask that question, because all of that was in the discussion. We talked about that. All of it was in the discussion on yesterday, and it was marvelous. Amen, amen, amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. What's your greatest testing of your faith? Think about it. Think about it. Think about it. Be refreshed. Tell your testimony to yourself. Amen. Encourage yourself on today. Amen. God gives us a rest. Remember, He told His disciples, He said, we've been working all day. Let's go away. Let's separate ourselves from the crowd, because the crowd will drain you. Amen. You will be depleted. He said, let's go away and rest. He took His disciples and rest. Amen. So we need that faith break. We need to stop and remember. Amen. Cause ourselves. We need an Ebenezer. You know, we need to remember how good God has been to us, and how far He has brought us on our faith journey. Amen. Amen. For we what grow from faith to faith. For from faith to faith, righteousness is revealed. Amen. That means we are changed. You can't have faith and say you're the same. It's a changing faith. We go from faith to faith. strength to strength, glory to glory. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Same grace. It's the same grace. Amen. It's the same grace. Amen. There's a grace on my life. There's a grace on your life. And that grace is to glorify God. We are in the earth to glorify God. We're in the earth to advance the kingdom of God. We're in the earth, amen, to be a witness to Jesus Christ so souls can be led to the cross for salvation. Amen. Amen. We are here as a light to this world of darkness. Amen. Amen. We have to believe by faith that it is so. That no matter what we go through, no matter what we feel, no matter what negative reports we hear, no matter the contrary word of God that's against God's word, we have to still believe the word of God. I don't care if you saying something about yourself. I know it's not true by the word of God. Now remember, I'm spiritual. Amen. I live in this earthly body. I still have to buffet my old flesh. I have to buffet. I have to work on it. I have, by the grace of God, by the Holy Spirit, by the word of God, that's what I do. But I don't look at that old flesh. Paul says to put off the old and put on the new. I walk in the new because I am in Christ Jesus. We have to get to that place by faith to know that our identity is in Christ Jesus. We rely on our struggles. We rely on our weaknesses. We say, God, look beyond our faults. God don't look over our faults. He's a holy God. He sent Jesus, the blood of Jesus, to be shed to wash that stuff away. We hold on to it. But God never just passed over sin. He doesn't do that. There was a penalty to be paid for our sin, and Jesus was that payment. We can't believe everything we hear. We can't just say stuff because it sounds good, because we don't have nothing else in our heart to say. The Bible talks about out of the heart, the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Put the word of God in your heart. Put the word of God in your heart so you begin to speak now from the abundance of your heart, which is the word of God, so you can talk the way you're supposed to talk. Jesus said, I say what my Father says, and I do what my Father does. We have to be about our Father's business. We have to advance the kingdom of God. Amen. 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 Glory to God. We have to be that light. We have to be a witness of Jesus Christ here in the earth. You don't have to be behind a pulpit to minister. You don't have to be. There are ministers who are pastors who don't get called to come preach behind a pulpit. They'll say something like this: I don't get that many opportunities to practice my craft. The devil is a liar. You can preach in your car. You can preach in your house. You can preach on YouTube. You can preach on Facebook. You can preach on Instagram. You can preach anywhere you want to preach. The ministry shouldn't be confined to four walls. It should not. Don't wait till someone invites you to their conference, or don't wait till someone invites you to their church, or so forth and so on. Begin to speak the word of God to one or 1,000, 100,000, 1,000,000. It does not matter. One at a time. Study the word of God. Be filled with the Spirit of God. Let him lead you. Let him guide you. Let him reveal to you the word of God. Let him teach you. Paul said, I did not confer with flesh and blood when I became saved. He is our teacher of truth. He's our revelation light of the word of God. You don't have to wait till someone invites you. You don't even have to wait till someone approve of you, because God has already approved of you. He's already ordained you. If you say God called you, find out why he called you. Ask him, God, what's my purpose in the earth? What am I supposed to do? Until you hear from him, preach the word of God in and out of season. Let someone be a witness of how good God has been to you, of how God saved you from the pit of hell, how he brought you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Faith on fire will be under fire. And the devil is a liar. Don't believe him. Don't believe him. Oh, don't believe him. The same grace that's on my life, it's the same grace that's available to you. Amen. Amen. I cannot do none of this without God. Amen. Without his spirit, without his word. Amen. And I love doing it. Amen. 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 I don't have to tell you everything behind the scenes and what's going on. It's a press because the enemy don't want us to be who God called us to be. The enemy don't want us to know our identity in Christ Jesus. We have to stop making our struggles. We have to stop making our weakness. We have to stop making our carnal mind, our carnal perception, our opinions, idols. But look to Jesus, who is the author and the perfecter of our faith. Amen. Glory to God. Advancing the kingdom of God. We're getting back to basics. Amen. We're getting back to what God called us to do. We're getting back to what the first century church was doing. Amen. We have an example. Amen. Look, go to the book of Acts. We'll get the example. Amen. Glory to God. And we have to stand firm on the word of God. Faith on fire will be a faith under fire. I am your host, Mary J. Bryant, with another segment of Faith in Action. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. I hope you have enjoyed this segment with me. Amen. I enjoyed it because the Holy Spirit does what he does, and I am available and surrendered to him. I just have to trust him. Amen. A lot of times we try to put confidence in our flesh, and our flesh will let us down because we get nervous, our minds lock up, you know, and so forth. But I trust the Holy Spirit. Once you let him lead you, you will be all right. You will be all right. If you want to learn more about this ministry, you can go to our website, www.doveministry378. That's the numbers 378.org. Amen. Amen. And why not consider letting us come and talk to you about your faith on fire so you can encourage others and also yourself? It's good to rehearse our faith on fire, isn't it? Glory to God. It causes us to remember. It causes us to remember. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. William Murphy. Sam Grace. Thank you, Lord. He's not.
Vine, I know we're not supposed to sing this tonight, but I keep hearing this. And after all that I've been through, I've got a story to tell you. He wouldn't let the devil consume me, because God knew he could use me.